why we're here today. It's gonna be wrong for a very long time.
Who's that?
It's my son and his friends. They just burn an awful little energy after the ride. We're gonna go fish on the other side.
From New Orleans, Louisiana, and just been following the oil spill. To come out and make a difference. I've been on the Audubon Institute email list, serve, and they sent out an opportunity to volunteer, so I signed up.
I live in Mobile, but my heart's in Louisiana.
My name's Chris Pulaski, and I'm an organizer with the National Wildlife Federation in HOMA.
If we can remove all the organic material and garbage off the edge of the beach, if the oil makes landfall, the oil won't stick to all that material. Because if the oil sticks to that material, it becomes hazardous waste.
My name is Natalie Snyder. I'm the science director for the Coalition to Restore Coastal Louisiana. We are working with a umbrella of conservation organizations that we call the Gulf Response Involvement Team, or GRIT. And GRIT is made up of the Coalition, the Bear Terrierbone National Estuary Program, National Wildlife Federation, National Audubon Society, and the Nature Conservancy. We have been working with BP to start involving unpaid volunteers who want to help, and we are looking at sites and situations that are safe and efficient for removal of material that could be covered in oil along the beaches.
This is, as far as I know, the first volunteer beach sweep or beach cleanup, and the purpose out here today is two-part, really. One is to get people out and involved. I know people are very anxious to help out, so we wanted to provide those in the local area with the ability to do that. But also, as things progress and as this continues to go along, we wanted to also identify potential team leaders that we can help build future volunteer efforts around.
Oh, it's awesome seeing everybody clean and keep the place clean. It's good. Keeps us coming back.
We hope with this event we can show the success and need for unpaid volunteers.
See it stay the way that you want it to be, then you got to do something about it, because sitting around at home and fixing anything.
My name is Rich Kudemarsh. I'm from Kingwood, Texas, outside the Houston, greater Houston area. Came here last night, drove about 7.5 hours with my wife so we could volunteer. When I got out of the Army as a captain, I started working for a company called Airborne Freight Corporation. We handled the charter operations, air charters for Exxon and other oil and petroleum companies. I think as we, as a country, start looking at going further below the ocean, we got to have more safety measures in place. I don't say that we should stop drilling, but we have to have all the solutions plotted before we tap into the well, especially since this one's still out of control and they're still looking for answers.